Hey, welcome back. Back to the basics. We're talking spanning tree. Let's go. Welcome back. We are talking spanning tree. We're talking everything from loop-free topologies to MST. All right, so hey, what is spanning tree? Well, spanning tree keeps a loop-free topology in a switched environment. So, for example, I plug in 4, 5, 6 different switches all in a big circle. Spanning tree will block one of those ports to keep a loop-free topology. And what does a loop-free topology mean? Well, it means that traffic, IP traffic, won't spin around and eventually take the network down because traffic continues to be forwarded in a circle. And because these devices' switches are fast, it would eventually flood the network and the network would be unusable. So spanning tree ensures that if we have redundantly connected switches or switches configured or connected in a loop, that it keeps the topology loop free, as I said before. There are many protocols, spanning tree protocols out there. To name a couple, there's obviously the spanning tree protocol STP, there is rapid STP, and there is MST, which is multiple spanning tree. And the difference between these protocols are things like timers, things like their ability. So MST, for example, will create essentially multiple databases on the topology, and you can put VLANs in different MST groups. With rapid spanning tree, you don't have that option, but you've got some tuning options. So things like uplink fast and backbone fast and things like that will help the process accelerate. So something like spanning tree port fast on a switch port for a Cisco switch will ensure that it goes through its spanning tree algorithm a lot faster than it would for a traditional port. So typically it's about a 30-second process. If I plug into a network port, it's gonna take 30 seconds before I can transmit data on that port. And so sometimes that's too long for things like, I don't know, people. Just in general, 30 seconds is a long time. So anyway, so things like DHCP, things like that can be somewhat of an issue if you have port fast not on. So essentially if it goes through that listening, learning, that whole process, that's the spanning tree process. If it goes through that, sometimes machines won't come onto the network. So turning on port fast ensures that the network is available and on very quickly for your users. That's about it with spanning tree, loop-free topology, pretty simple. All right, hey, if there was anything in this video that I said that you go, hey, I'd love to know more about that, make sure you leave a comment, or you could say, at Looking Point, you can go, hey, give me some more content about this, and we'll try to do it for you. Make sure you like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.